Well, people all around the Piedmont are celebrating the season tonight, including in Yadkinville at WXII's second food drive of the holidays. Cameron Kent is out there live tonight. You seeing a lot of last-minute donations, Cam?
We have got a steady stream of people stopping in, and we're probably having more fun out here than we ought to have. We got Landon Parker from Fort Bush High School. You probably know him as the winner of the Triad's Got Talent competition. Somebody stopped by and gave me some cookies, which I will eat later, but I'm fine. I got enough to eat. It is everybody else in our community who needs food. We filled up close to 15 boxes, but we want to get to 30. So if you have a chance, stop on by. Now, helping us out is WTQR and Jeff Roper. You hear him every single morning, and you've had a good time. I'm out here talking to folks.
It's been really good. Insulated underwear helps, and you know, Cameron's got on lots of hairspray, and we didn't tell you that the first person to bring a $100 check out here gets to mess up his hair.
Oh, no, that's tonight. News to me, too.
For the second harvest food bank.
But aren't you surprised, pleasantly surprised, how many people stop by and just want to help?
You know, I'm not really surprised because the hearts of the people here in the Triad, they're so giving. There's so many folks that are having a hard time right now with the economy and so many folks that are so blessed, and they're giving back. And today is National Pay It Forward Day, and so we've been talking about that all day. Yeah. It's been great.
Well, we appreciate WTQR being out here, and he was just kidding about that hair thing, I think.
No, no, we're not.
All right, let's step over here and talk to Chuck Harmon. We asked people for non-perishable food items. What are some of the things that you really need?
Well, you know, all the canned staple items, green bean, corn, tuna in a can, good meal for us, peanut butter, those type of things, non-perishable canned goods, much as people want to give, we can put to use.
And you were saying before, I don't think a lot of people realize that, just how many hungry children there are in our area.
Oh, yeah, you know, ranking up there number one with Louisiana in children's birth to 5 years old that are food insecure, you know, and that's nothing to be number one in the nation with, you know. A lot of kids, man, and from kids to old folks and everybody in between, nobody should have to go without a meal this holiday season.
And if you can't stop by here, you can always log on to their website and make a cash donation, and a $1 donation goes a long way.
Oh, yes, $1 donation, 7 meals, and they can do that by logging on to hungernwnc.org.
All right, thanks very much, Chuck Harmon with the Second Harvest Food Bank. This gentleman back here brought everybody some hot chocolate,
Woo!
Which we appreciate. I drank one cup, I poured the other cup down my shoes, so I'm feeling pretty good. Wanda, I'm going to send it back to you. Stop on by, folks, if you're anywhere near the Lowe's Food in Yadkinville.
All right, thanks a lot, Cam. It is cold out there, no doubt about it.